Alright, so now we're going to learn how to add the remote access. And we're going to do this in the 411 server 2 right there. So we're going to go to add roles and features. We're going to click next. And then we're going to click next. All the way until we get down to the roles right here, which has remote access right there. And then we're going to select all three of these, click add features, and then click next and then install. Then you click close. So in Activity 5-2, you'll right-click the Start button and go to Network Connections. And here they say to use the second network interface and go to Properties. And then here we'll go to TCP IPv4, go to Properties, and we'll set these settings just like that to 203.0.113.1, and enter a default subnet mask. And our next step is to close all that out. And we'll be going to Tools. And under here, we'll have our routing and remote access. And then our next step, we're going to be going up to Configure and Enable Routing and Remote Access. And we'll click Next here. We're going to do remote access, dial up our VPN, and click next. And then we're going to click VPN. Then we'll click next after that. And then we're going to click the IP address with the 203.0.113.1, the one that we picked. And then we're going to go ahead and keep this selected right there. And our next step is to click next. And from here, and from right here, we're going to go ahead and go from a specific range of addresses. Click next on that one. And now we'll go ahead and click new. And right on here, we're going to do 10, 11, 0, 100. And number of addresses, we'll go ahead and click 10 there, and then click OK. And now it'll show it right in there. Then we'll go ahead and click next right after that. And we'll be clicking next and then finish. And actually, a lot of machines will say this, it'll say that's unable to add this computer. So we can just click OK on that. And just click OK on that too. It's supposed to be, that's actually supposed to be correct. So now for activity 5-3, we'll go ahead and we're going to close out a couple of those windows. There we go, close out of that one. Then we're going to go ahead and we're going to be creating a user. So just right click there, go to computer management. And local users and groups. So we're going to go ahead and create a new user here under that submenu there. Then we're going to make the username VPN test1. And then we're going to use our default password that we've been using for everything else, which is a capital P, and the word password, basically, and 01. And then what you do is you uncheck mark that one, and you check mark this one for password never expires. And we're going to click create. And then we're going to close out of there. right here to get the properties dialog box. Then we're going to go into the dial in tab. We're going to go to allow access. Then we're going to go ahead and click OK. And we're going to log into our Windows 8 server here. So log into your Windows 8 user. And then we're going to go down to our desktop, right click the start button, and go to network connections. Then on here, we're going to go ahead and change our IP address. IPv4, and in here we're going to change some of the settings. We're going to set this to 203, zero, 113, and 10, and subnet mask as the default 255, 255, 255, 0. And then we're going to go ahead and click OK. And we can go ahead and close this part here. Then we're going to close out of this. And we'll go to our control panel. We're going to go to our network and sharing center. Go ahead and set up a new connection. We're going to connect to our workplace. Click next. And we're going to use the VPN right there. They say I'll set up an internet connection later. And then we're going to go ahead and put the internet address as 203.0. .113.1. And we'll go ahead and click create. And we're going to click VPN connection right here. Then click connect. Type in the 411 server 2 / VPN test 1 and our password 01. And I did have a little problem at first connecting, so what I ended up doing was I went to the Ethernet adapter and I checked the IP address, and that pretty much fixed that problem there. And I'll show you right now what you need to type in there. So basically I had to put the IP address in there. And I also had to do one more setting. So basically right there, the EAP that I enabled, and then that's what fixed my issue I had also with my connection. Then on the next step, you shut down your Windows 8 server here. to server 2 here. Disable our routing and remote access. And we just click yes on that. Service. Then we go to IPv4. We go here to static routes. And then we're going to go to show IP routing table. Static route, and right here in the destination part, we're going to put 203.0.1140, and then we're going to do 255.255.255.0. And the gateway is going to be our 203.0.1.1.3.1. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to click OK on that. And then we can right click the static routes here and show IP routing table. Looks like it's showing it there. Alright, now we're going to go to our general tab here. Right here to IPv4 general tab. And if you right click that, you could do new routing protocol. Inside of here, we're going to do the RIP version 2 for internet protocol. There, we'll right click it, and then we're going to put new interface. And we're just going to click basically OK right here. And then on the property dialog box right here, it's asking us a few things. So we're just going to click OK on here. And we actually want to go ahead and do the Ethernet 1 there, and click OK. And then we're going to go ahead and show neighbors.